So, Sarah Moretti is a snail in her aquarium. She notices that this morning it crawled 1 inch above the glass. So, let us assume that this is the glass. Yeah. So, this is 1 inch of the glass. A few hours later, it crawled another 2 inches. So, it will read 3 inches. Mr. Sarthak, okay?
Yes, sir.
And then what it does is, I'll have to make this glass bigger. So, maybe I'll make the glass like this. So maybe the snail started from here. This was the snail initial. Yeah. So it went 1 inches above and then 2 inches above. It crawled 4 inches down the glass and then it came 4 inches down. So this distance will be? Mr. Sarthak?
4.
Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Is there any confusion?
No, sir.
See, whenever you face any difficulty, whenever you are facing any difficulty, please try to draw a figure. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Can you do this question? Question number 2.
Sir, do I have to write the money paid by Henry's sister also in the entry?
See, Henry started the day with $30. So, he had $30. He pays for his own admission of $10. So what should I do? Should I add or should I subtract?
Subtract.
Subtract. But fails to notice that $15 falls out of his wallet. So should I add or subtract?
Subtract.
Subtract. His sister lends him $10. Should I add or subtract?
Add.
So what will be the answer? The net answer will be?
So we don't have to write it for the sister.
No. His day is financially worse. What would be the net answer?
So I'm just subtracting.
Sorry?
So I'm just calculating.
Yeah.
$25.
So 30 and 10 is 40. So $40 is plus 10 and 15 is minus $25. So the answer would be? Mr. Sarthak? Sarthak, the answer would be?
$35.
No, 40 minus 25. Is there any confusion?
No, sir.
How did you get 35?
So I added 1 by minus the tens place.
I'm sorry. Achha. 40 minus 25 would be $15. Is there a problem?
No, sir.
Okay. Can you do question number 4? Have you understood the question?
Yes, sir. So $7.
See, Felicia owns her dad $5. She earns $12 doing the chores. This is the money that her father would have given her. And she already owes $5. So the answer would be $7. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Can you do fifth question?
So I have done.
Okay. So what is the answer?
24.
Okay. So elevator started at the first floor. Went up 18 floors. From first, it went up 18 floors. So it would have reached 19th floor. This was first. It then came down 11 floors. It then came down 11 floors. So minus 11. It would have reached the 8th floor. And went back 16. Again, it went back 16 floors. So it would have reached 24th floor. Mr. Sarthak, what was your answer?
24.
Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
See, these questions become easier if you draw a diagram. Otherwise, they become difficult. Is there any problem?
No, sir.
Can you do 6th question?
So 36 degrees Celsius.
Okay. So something. One thing that you need to understand is that this is Fahrenheit. Do you know anything about Fahrenheit? Have you heard about Fahrenheit?
Yes, sir.
This is Fahrenheit. Temperature can be measured as Celsius or it can be measured as Fahrenheit. So one is that you need to check in what units the temperature is being measured. So the temperature was 30 degree Fahrenheit. This was 30 degree Fahrenheit. It dropped 5 degrees. It had dropped 5 degrees. And by noon, it had increased by 11 degrees. It had dropped 5 degrees. So it became 25 degree Fahrenheit. Sarthak, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
And then it increased by 11 degree Fahrenheit. So here, it increased by 11 degree Fahrenheit. So it would have reached 36 degree Fahrenheit. Sarthak, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
What was the answer that you had got?
36 degree Fahrenheit.
Perfect. That's two, question number 7.
So minus 16.
Okay. Some number added to 5 is equal to minus 11. So we have 5 here. When I added something to it, the answer that I got was minus 11. So this is my original number. If I add, or I can write it like this, or I can even write it like this, 5 plus minus 11. Both ways, the answer that I will get is minus 11.
Yes, sir.
So minus 11 is, so my answer would be minus 16. Perfect. Very nice, Mr. Sarthak. Okay. Question number 8.
So 4299 feet.
So from the top of a mountain to the floor of the valley is 4392 feet. So the situation would be something like this. This would be the valley. And this will be the top of the mountain.
No, but it's below sea level.
If the valley is 93 feet below sea level, yeah. Right. Now.
So what is the sea level?
Sir, sea level is considered to be zero. So, whenever you see sea level, you can consider it to be zero. So, the situation would be something like this. And this is the sea. Let us assume that this is land. And then there is some valley like this. And this is the mountain. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So it will be something like this. So this is sea here. And sea level is considered to be zero. This is 0 meters. Is there any difficulty?
So 0 feet.
0 feet or 0 meter or whatever. Yes, it should be feet. So just remember that whatever units are given, so it will be 0 feet. Perfect. Now the situation is from the top of a mountain to the floor of the valley below is 4392 feet. So from the top to the valley, this whole distance is 4392 feet. If the valley is 93 feet below sea level, so this distance is 93 feet below. Mr. Sarthak, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
I have to find the height of the mountain. Basically, what he's trying to tell you is that find the height of the mountain, basically, above sea level. So in geography, maybe they would teach you or they would have already taught you, all distances are measured from sea level. And sea level is considered to be zero. So I need to find this height. And this height will be equal to 4392 minus 93 feet. Mr. Sarthak, what answer did you get?
So 4299.
4299 feet. Yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you do question number 9?
So 1229.
During 1 week, the stock market did the following. Monday rose 18 points. So 18 would be positive or negative? Plus 18. Thursday rose 13. Tuesday rose 31 points. Wednesday dropped 5 points. Thursday rose 27 points. Friday dropped 38 points. Is it right, Mr. Sarthak?
Yes, sir.
What answer did you get?
71. No, 33.
Okay, let me check. So 18 and 31 would be 49. 49 and 26. 49 and 26. Would be equal to 76. Minus 5 and minus 38 would be minus 43. So the final answer will be 33. Is this answer correct?
Yes, sir.
Now this is positive. Now, it started with 1196. It has rows a total of 33. So what will be my final answer? See, started at 1196. So the final answer would be?
1229.
1196 plus 33. So 63993. 12. 1229. Perfect, sir. Very nice. Okay. Question number 10.
So 14551.
Okay. It even started at 0 feet. It was 21,000 plus 21,000. It descended 4329 because of clouds. Oncoming plane was approaching, so it rose 6333 feet. After the oncoming, it descended 8453 feet. At what altitude was the plane flying? So this is what you would have written first. Step one. This is step one.
Yes, sir.
Then you would have added these two and added these two. So when I add these two, the answer that I will get is 3327 feet. And when I add these two, the answer that I will get is 9 3 12 5 7 8 4 3 7 8 4 12. Mr. Sarthak, this is the answer. 2733 minus 12782 feet. Yes or no, sir?
Yes, sir.
Then you subtracted these two. The final answer that you would have got is 3 to the 1. 13 and 8 is 5. 12 and 7 is 5. 6 and 2 is 4. 2 and 1 is 1. Is this the final answer?
Yes, sir.
So if I want to check this, I will add this and this. So 2 plus 1 is 3. 8 plus 5 is 13. 8 plus 5 is 13. 3 plus 4 is 7. And 1 plus 1 is 2. So this is correct. Very good, Mr. Sarthak. Okay, let us skip this. Okay, let us do question number 12.
So 37 miles per hour.
Okay. Jim decided to go for a drive. He started at 0. He then accelerated to 20. Then he got into the highway. He accelerated another 35 miles per hour. Car was going slow in front of him, so he slowed by 11. He then go off the highway, so he slowed down another 7. So 35 plus 20 is 55 minus 18. The final answer is, Mr. Sarthak?
37
miles per hour. And if I want to check, 8 plus 7 is 15. 3, 4, 5. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mr. Sarthak, let us do some more questions. Can you do this question, please? Question number 1. Have you done it?
No, sir. So 27716.
Okay. So this is my sea level. Yeah. And the Dead Sea, the lowest elevation is 1312 feet below sea level. So let us assume that this is some land. And we have this to be the Dead Sea. And from Dead Sea, let us assume that this is Dead Sea, this is our sea level, which is 0 feet. Now, Dead Sea is 1312 feet below sea level. And Mount Everest is 29028 feet above sea level. So this level this level would be 29028 feet. Mr. Salvi, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So this is how the situation is. And what they want is, what is the difference between these two elevations? So, Mr. Sartak, how will I do it?
So 29028 minus 1312.
See, I have to find the difference between the height of this top and this bottom. That is what I need to find.
Yes, sir.
So what do you think the answer would be?
First, we have to add.
You have to add. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So in all these questions, so something in all these questions, always try to make a photograph, a rough diagram, so that you understand. Because I understand that when you see difference, you will try to subtract. But the situation is completely different. You need to 29028 plus 1312. You need to add the two numbers. Have you understood why?
Yes, sir.
Because finally, the difference between the heights would be from here till here. And this would be... Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Can you do question number two? So always try to make diagrams like these. You can draw a rough diagram. And in questions like these, you can have a number line so that there is no confusion. So, question number two, please.
-21 degrees Fahrenheit.
So let me check. In Buffalo, New York, the temperature was -14 degrees in the morning. The temperature dropped 7 degrees Fahrenheit. So it dropped. So the temperature would be -21 degrees Fahrenheit. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Can you do question number three?
So 1050 feet.
Okay. So this is the sea level. And this is your submarine. Now the submarine is 800 feet below sea level. Now it ascends. Ascend means it goes up 250 feet. So it comes to this level. Now what they want is, what is the new position? They want...
The ascends means goes down, right?
But it ascends and descends. So, what will descend mean?
Going down.
Down. Ascend will up. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So, D descends, D down. And ascends is opposite, so it has to go up. So, what will be the answer? What will be this answer?
800 minus 250.
Correct. What will be my answer? 800 minus 250 will be?
550 feet.
Now the answer that you should write like 550 feet below sea level. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Because if you write 550 feet, if you write answer only to be 550 feet, your teacher can't make out that whether it is 550 feet is above sea level or below sea level. This is not clear. So you should write complete answer in this. Sadhak, is there a problem?
No, sir.
Can you do question number four?
So 192 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay. So Sahara, it was 136 degrees Fahrenheit. Gobi Desert, it was minus 50 degrees Fahrenheit. I need to find the difference between these two. So it will be 136 minus 50. This will be 186 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes or no, sir?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Saltik, is there any confusion?
No, sir. I just, to make it easy, I had added 6 and then forgot to subtract 6 after.
Mr. Saltik, you need to cross-check. You need to check your answer again. Otherwise, you lose a lot of marks. Okay. Let us do question number 6. Question number 6.
So 15 feet above ground level.
Okay, let us check. So roller coaster begins 90 feet above, then descends 105 feet. So this would be the ground level. Descends 105 feet. This is 105 feet. This is the ground level. This would be 0 feet. Find the height of the coaster after the first descent. This answer would be, Mr. Sarthak, what answer have you got?
15 feet.
Then it will be minus 15 feet. Have you understood?
Sir, but why?
Okay. See, I can write this as 15 feet below ground level. So, if you write 15 feet only, then it is incorrect. So, either I write it is 15 feet below ground level, or I write my answer is minus 15 feet. This minus implies that you have now actually gone below ground level. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood or not?
Yes, sir.
See, the roller coaster begins at 90 feet above the ground level. So, this would be the ground level. Now, if it has descended 105 feet, it would have actually gone below ground level. Yes or no, sir?
Yes, sir.
See, it is very simple. So, for example, in your building also, usually what happens is, I'll draw a rough picture and you'll understand that what happens. So, for example, in Bombay, you would have seen a lot of buildings, or maybe in your building also, the same thing would be happening, and I'll show you what happens. Now, this is how the buildings are constructed. This is how the buildings are constructed. That this is a podium. This is a podium level. Now you might be staying on the. So this is your reception. This is your reception. You might be staying on the second floor, right? But your parking would be. This is the first level parking. First level parking. This is the second level parking. And this would be the third level parking. Now, this first level parking, second level parking, third level parking are below the ground level or the podium level. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So you would have seen this such kind of buildings, or you might be living in such a building. For example, from second floor, when the lift goes, when you enter the lift, it takes you below the podium level. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
When you are standing on the third level parking, or maybe when you're, I'll make some space here. Maybe when your car is parked here, So your car is actually this much feet or meter below the ground level. Have you understood or not?
Yes, sir.
And then maybe you can take a spiral or maybe whatever they have and you can go to the ground level and go up. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.